together. Your throne I will destroy. He has given us words in order. Those walls will have to fall. It's a prophecy he has spoken. Iron bars are falling down. And the people shout, 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 shout. Shout, 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 we'll be right back.
Him, beside Him there is no other. Declare it tonight. Hey, High God.
You are the Most High God, Jehovah.
Glory.
Let him hear you declare it in the atmosphere tonight. No foreign God. It's you that I love. It's you that I love. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. No foreign God. No foreign God. It's you that I love. It's you. It's you, God, I love. I really love you, Lord. Shh. It's you. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. It's you that I love. 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 It's you that no foreign God. No foreign God. No, 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 no foreign. No foreign God can take his place. And as we were singing that the song, I think the Holy Spirit truly wants to do a house cleaning for us as Christians. For some of us, we have been doing it out of ignorance. For some of us, we have been doing it out of fear. For others, we have been doing it to get protection. But we've been practicing a lot of things and exalting other gods besides Jehovah God. So for those of you who, when you had a newborn baby, you think it's protection to use blue to rub under the feet for protection. And from others, you might have had the harsh shoe over your door. And for some, you cannot sweep your house after 6 o'clock. It's just, you feel as if you're going to die if you sweep your house after 6 o'clock. And you have to turn that broom upside down. And many of us, we have to have the garlic and the lime in our cars or in our purses. But tonight, the Lord wants us to do internal housekeeping. Because no foreign God, no foreign God, no foreign God. It's the blood of Jesus. It's the blood of Jesus. It's the blood of Jesus. Only the blood. Only the blood. Woo! Yes, Holy Ghost. those very dear friends that we call friends, and they have to encourage us. If anything seems to be going wrong in our lives, they are the ones to encourage us, girl or boy. You have to go look. You have to go see what, who did you what. Church of God, there's only one God. 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 Church here, we've been singing that song, which the Holy Spirit just have us singing it and singing it. And brethren, the Lord wants us to remove everything and anything that is unlike God. And so, many of you tonight, you have it stuck. They gave it to you to put for women. They gave it to you to put it in your bras. You have to wait around your waist. Those of us who are building homes, before they cast the cistern, we have to bury it in there. No, the blood of Jesus, no. But we know it's the truth. We know it's the truth. And so because of these things, and these things bring on fear. And so if you don't do it, you feel as if you're going to die, the world is going to fall apart, that everything wrong is going to happen. But brethren, tonight we sang earlier that we love God, and we have to, He is the awesome God, and we must trust Him. If you're feeling sick, you must trust Him. If things are going wrong, you must trust Him. If you have lost your job, you have to trust Him. We must trust Him and Him alone. No foreign God. No foreign God. So you don't have to go to St. Thomas and the other Caribbean islands to take your bath and all these things. Even here in Virgin Gorda, the Holy Spirit wants us as believers to let God reign and rule supreme. For Him alone to reign, no other God, no other God. And it's a very serious thing. The Lord takes it very seriously. He says, if you touch anything occultic, it goes on. And I was supposed to look back this reference to how much generations. It was several generations you bring in a curse on. When you and I dabbled with any, in the slightest way, in the slightest way, we are bringing on damnation unto our children, children's children. But the blood of Jesus prevails tonight. And if you tonight, whether out of fear, out of ignorance, or out of wanting protection, we're going to ask God to forgive us tonight. We're going to ask God to forgive us. Because I know it's a culture many times that if you have a new baby, some people, I see that, you know, they don't even want anybody to, they don't want to take the child out because the child isn't christened yet. The child isn't christened yet. And you have to rub that blue under the foot for the protection. Let us bow our heads and raise our hands tonight. Father God, we have erred. Our parents have passed on these traditions and have instilled fear into our lives. And we, because of it, our mothers, the monarchs of the family, we have taken their advice. We have done these things out of ignorance. And as a result of this ignorance, we have continued it during our adult lives. So we want protection for our jobs. We want protection. We want to keep our husbands. We want to keep this and we want to keep that. So we have gone on and doubled more and more and more. We ask that you will forgive us tonight. Forgive us, Holy Ghost. Forgive us. Jesus, forgive us. We ask you for blood covering upon our children that we have passed it on to. Forgive us, Holy Ghost. Spirit of the living God, forgive us tonight. Forgive us, Lord. For we have not placed rocks, or worship rocks, but we have placed these things, these traditions, and we have held on to them as if they can do what you only can do. So, Lord, forgive us. Forgive us. Purify our children. Sanctify our children. Sanctify our homes. Sanctify our homes. Sanctify our cars, our possessions, God. Forgive us, Holy Ghost. Forgive us. For truly you are the only God. You are the only God that deserves to be worshipped. You are the only God that deserves to be praised. And so, God, we worship you tonight. Forgive us, Lord. Cleanse us from these iniquities. Purify our hearts, our minds, and help us to trust you and trust you alone. In Jesus' awesome name, and the church says, amen. Amen. As believers, we must believe God. We must believe God. We must, we must, we must. If we don't believe God, then it becomes easy for us to dabble in the occult. And it becomes so easy after a while. But God wants to break loose in Virgin Guyana. And in order for him to break loose, we have to break loose of these traditions. We have to break loose of the way that we are thinking, so that the Lord could have his way and do what he must do tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you very much, Emmanuel. Back there. Give our good visiting choir, worship team. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You may have your seats tonight. We are so happy to see all of you in the house tonight. We are here for an awesome time in the presence of the Lord. The Lord has already been here, spoken to us, and we are glad. For those of you visiting from the other churches, just raise your hand and shout, I'm here! All right, stand up, home, say, I'm here! All right. All right. We also happy to have Evangelist Maxine Johnson, who is, we welcome her back home. And we'll be hearing from her later on. But I just saw her walk in just a moment ago. Prophetess Sheila Morris. God bless you. So happy to have you. You're here. Happy to have you. And we also have Pastor Gregory Smith and his wife, Sister Sandra. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. At this time, we're going to continue worshiping the Lord in our giving and go straight into so that we can have the speaker can have as much time as she needs to deliver the word. Last night, she told us she put 7 messages in one. Tonight, I guess we're going to get 8 messages in one. Can I ask the ushers to come quickly as we receive the offering tonight? And as you come through the middle, last time we had the same problem. Please don't try to go back to your seat through the middle. Just go back to your seat on the side. And be careful. You can pass that way as well. Just yes. So Elder Lana, can you stand there at the end to just help them direct so they don't bump on anything? But please don't go back to the middle. You find that you'll be bumping on folks as you go back. Amen. Pastor Greg. A love. Can you ask God blessing on the offering for us tonight, please, sir?
Good night. I normally do things a little bit differently in our house, right? So we're going to just stand. You're going to make a declaration over your own finances. You often believe yourself more than you believe anybody else. Amen? Hold your offering in your hand and say after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for the pleasure of giving. I thank you for the place to give. And I thank you for the power of giving. Father God, your word says that as we give, it shall be given back to me. Pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give into my bosom. I believe your word. I receive your word. And I believe that that word is working for me tonight in the name of Jesus. So I release my seed with faith, and I expect, come on, I expect a harvest in return in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Come as we give tonight. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord.
Oh, holy you be God, oh, holy you be God, oh. Oh, holy you be God, oh, holy you be God, oh. Oh, holy you be God, oh, holy you be God, oh. Oh, holy you be God, oh. That I am. If you hold them any further, your throne I will destroy. He has given us virgin daughter. Those walls will have to fall. Yes, the bars he has broken. Iron bars have fallen down. Let the people shout, 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 shout. Shout, 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 shout. Let the people shout, 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 shout. Come on, shout, shout, shout. Let the people shout, 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 shout.
Hallelujah. Come on, somebody holler another good hallelujah. 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 Yes, I get to preach after me. It's so wonderful to have everybody. Wonderful to have my good friend and colleague in ministry. I mean, recently he's telling everybody we're not a good friend because of call people and the other sort of things. But we are good friends. We are good friends. Me no matter if you don't want to be my friend, I'm your friend. Understand that? Because I can't do it without you, so that's all right. All right? I love you. I'm not calling you, but everybody knows who you talk, right? All right, all right. Sister Sandra, it's such wonderful, wonderful to have you tonight. Such a wonderful pleasure to have you. Oh, Lord have mercy. I thought both of you were ones. If I call one name, it's all right. And it cover both of you. Why are you so jealous? We always calling your name. Come on, man. That spirit of Trump coming upon you now. Trump anointing. No, come on. We're people from Emmanuel Baptist. So we're buying that in Jesus' name. No, sir. No, sir. Not our pastor. If you don't have good friends that you can laugh with sometimes, the stiffness of life, life will truly box you down. So it's always good to have. I want to thank Emmanuel Baptist Church, really. They did not plan to leave tonight, and they had to make us of adjustment. People have to come from Tortola and all sort of things. And that symbol, that's a symbol, symbolism of a good friend, one who is willing to walk the extra mile, right? As, you know, when I spoke to him, he was saying that I should have told him in advance. I said, man, what kind of foolishness you have got? I call you, listen, I call you in the morning, I tell you I need you for the night, you show up. I don't have no attitude about it neither. And I said, just show up and do your thing. And I give you from Sunday, and you're talking, you know. But don't get between us, it's how we live. It's how we live. The prior group want us to use this opportunity to announce that they're having a food sale, it's a pre-Valentine food sale, and February 11th, Dukuna, Roti, and all sorts of goodies. Tickets are for $10. I understand that they only have they don't have endless supplies. So our first come, first serve. See Sister London or somebody from out the prior team. They're raising money to take care of some stuff. I know they're having a prayer conference that they are so excited about. It's good to have the prophetess in the house. Wonderful to have you. We have looked forward to this. All right? Since November, we have been itching to do this. So I'm glad that you're finally here, and we're looking forward to tomorrow night when the Lord will begin to download in our spirit what God have laid in your spirit. We are really, really happy to have you. It is it's indeed a privilege, and I hope I'm not forgetting anybody. If there are any other pastors here, we salute you. We don't see beyond the third benches. Apologize for that. But all the rest of the church is. It's good to have Evangelist Maxine Johnson with us. As you heard, this is her home. She's coming in for 19 years. 19 years she has become a part, a fixture of the community. And it's always such a blessing to have her. Since that first time when she came and shared her testimony. And she haven't bothered to tell it to us. You know why she haven't shared about the testimony? After she shared the testimony, I begged her some of her money. She decided she's not sharing that one again. But I haven't forgotten that the Lord bless her. I think it was 1983 or 1984 and turned her into a multi-millionaire instantly. I haven't forgotten that. I haven't forgotten, you know. She gave up something when she was 12 years old. Her mother, she walked away to serve God. And in 1983, 1984, God changed her life. Brought a woman into her life. Adopted her. And did for her what no mother could have done. I am proud to say I've been to the house in New Jersey. Sure, the thing look good. The thing look good. Because when God intends to bless you, God will bless you crazy. And so we are extremely happy to have a servant who is not just preaching it, but she's living it. She's a living testimony of the miracles that God has worked all over and as God continues to use him. Will you stand with me tonight and allow God's servant to know that we're extremely happy to have her serving us in this part of the neck. Come on, put your hands together for her as she comes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody, lift up your hands and give God some praise at this time. If you know that you know that you know that your Redeemer liveth. If you know that God is your still Jehovah Jireh. If you know that God is still your God that never leaves you nor forsake you. If you know that your God is still the balm in Gilead. I dare you to open up your mouth and scream like you're losing your mind. Oh, come on, praise him like you never praised him before. Somebody give him glory. Somebody give him glory. Somebody give him glory. Oh, somebody give him glory. I learned a long time ago. Praise will break the enemy's camp. I don't know if anybody been going under some attack. Anybody who know that you have been filled with the Holy Ghost, you have been serving God, you have been paying your tithes, you have been committed to God, but somewhere the enemy keep attacking you. But I come to release that if you ever open up your mouth,
God, let praise become your weapon. Let praise become your weapon. I said, let praises become your weapon. I learned a long time ago that I am not gonna back up against the wall without a fight. You must learn to fight. It's worth fighting for. Your breakthrough worth fighting for. Your deliverance worth fighting for. Your ministry worth fighting for. Oh, you're not screaming like you're losing your mind up in here. I said your breakthrough worth fighting for. Your miracles worth fighting for. I've been through some things in life and I'm still going through, but it worth fighting for. Somebody come on up, please. Somebody over here. Something you must fight for. Fight to get back your breakthrough. Fight to get back your joy. Fight to get back your peace. Fight to get back the revival. Fight to get back the miracle that we lost. Somebody that's screaming up in here. I said fight to get it back. Somebody tell your neighbor, I'm gonna get it back. I'm gonna get back my inheritance. I'm gonna get back my breakthrough. I'm gonna get back my deliverer. I'm gonna get it back in the name of Jesus. Rosha baba baba de 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 bossa. Rebe de 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 bossa. La 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 baba baba sete. Somebody praise him. Somebody praise him. Somebody praise him. Somebody praise him. Yes, God, I'm gonna make you sit on down, but I come to release another year of anointing. Pastor Greg, I made up my mind. What I lost 2015, what I lost 2013 and 14, I am not gonna lose nothing this year. Nothing is broken. Nothing is broken. I said nothing is broken this year. I come to release a prophetic over our lives. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. I believe Brother Job was in a place like you and I. Though he slay me, yet will I trust him. All of my appointed time. I'm gonna wait until my change come. Come on, just take another 60 seconds and lift up your hands and open up your mouth and let the devil be a liar. Let the devil be a liar. Say it. Say it. Oh, turn around and tell about 7 people God's got a miracle with your name written on it. Come on, say, God's got a miracle with your name. Only your name. Come on, come on, tell somebody else. God's got a miracle. God's got a miracle, baby. I don't know when it's releasing, but God's got a miracle. I don't know when it's gonna be releasing, but God's got a miracle. I don't know what time is coming to me, but God's got a miracle. I don't know how it's gonna happen, but God's got a miracle. With my name written on it. Come on, somebody. As our pastor Bishop told you about my testimony in 1993, how I was preaching in our London, never know this woman, and the woman came to the service. Come on, y'all. Just came to visit the service, and I'm not getting into testimony, but how the Lord would place people at the right place at the right time to pull you out of what you're going through. Bishop, she came to do what she had to do. I am not even here. I don't know where she's up. Somewhere on the ground in Korea. She went back home to do missionary work. That's where she's from. Can you imagine a Korean adopt a black girl? Can you imagine when I was 33 years old, was legally adopted? Can you imagine? I mean legally adopted. Can you imagine when I was 3 years old, her mama prophesied to her that you're going to adopt a child out of your race? Did not manifest till 30 years later. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, I'm waiting on that. The house I live in, I did not pay a dollar for it. The two cars that I drive, 1994 and 1996, I didn't pay a dollar for it. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. And a matter of fact, from that time, I don't know what it is to buy a car. The rest of it, my church stopped buying it for me. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. I don't see her no more. I don't hear from her no more. But God will send her. And I was preaching in another state the other day. I did not know this woman. A matter of fact, the woman came from Grand Cayman. And she prophesied over me. Did not know nothing about me. She first time she see me. And she prophesied. Just about in what, December, November, somewhere there. She prophesied October, somewhere there. She prophesied that bishop. And she said, God said to tell you, he's gonna do it again. Let me get in the way. So everywhere I go, I am focusing like Elijah and Elisha. I am looking for my Elijah. Because she did what she had to do. Her assignment was complete. Can I get a witness on here? Let me with a roof over my head. That as long as I live, nobody will ever put me out of my house. It's bought cash. I will never experience foreclosure on a house. God said to tell me again, he's gonna do it again. That means he's sending another person to take me to the next level. Somebody slap about 2-3 people. I said, God is gonna do it again. He's my witness. He came to my house. He's gonna do it again, Pastor. I came just to release this. I was wondering if you wasn't gonna come check around me and see about me. I was wondering if you just leave me hanging. I wanted to have some lunch with you and you was not here. My God Almighty, I'm cutting you off. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. But I come to release this tonight that God is going to do it for you again. So sit on down, but before you sit on down, grab your neighbor and say, neighbor, stop worrying about that thing. God is going to fix it for you. He's going to do it again. Scream like you're losing your I want to take this great opportunity in honoring this great, great man of God, Bishop Paul Ricketts, my friend, my brother. Amen. Long time coming, for 19 years. Amen. As a matter of fact, I know a little bit about his parents in Jersey before. Amen. In Plainfield. So we kind of connect for a long time. Amen. We thank God for him and his lovely wife, First Lady Ricketts. Help me salute and praise God for them. Awesome man of God. An awesome, awesome woman of God. Amen.
and to all of God's trust servants. Amen. I heard about this great woman coming to take about her from me tomorrow night. I know you're going to preach them crazy, so let me get out of here. Amen. God bless you, woman of God. Amen. And I learned a long time ago is that we don't even have to act like we're cute. All of us know what ministry can bring sometimes. Amen. It brings us to the highest level, and sometimes it keeps us in the valley. Amen. But we thank God that we are winners through Jesus Christ. And I thank God for you as well. And to Pastor Greg Simmons, God bless you. Amen. And woman of God, First Lady, God bless you. Amen. I am so glad to have everybody with us. Amen. Amen. Somebody shout glory to God. Last but not least, I want to say thank you. A very big thank you to my armor bearer. Amen. This is my armor bearer in the islands. Amen. And she's what a fantastic woman she is. She served me with integrity. And I think she'd been rolling with me since I was preaching in Totola. Amen. From back then, she was at that church, and then I came over here and was like, what in the world? And she has been serving me since then. Amen. So I'm so grateful for her. She's the one of a kind. God bless you. And I trust that everything you need, God will provide and make a way out of nowhere. Somebody said amen. All right, I'm going to take it straight to the word. God gave me a word all week long. Matter of fact, this week was just a week that I did not have to have pressure to go and look for a lot of scriptures to do a lot of different messages. God just took me from one message Sunday morning, the year of the anointing, the year of favor, and the year of victory. Amen. So I completed victory last night, and I am going to conclude it with the year of mercy. You got to roll with me, baby. You got to roll with me. Roll with me. Roll with me. All right. They roll with me all week. Roll with me. Roll with me. Somebody shout glory. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Amen. It's the year of miracle. And so I want you to turn your Bibles with me to St. Luke. Amen. Send the book of St. Luke. I'm so glad to have all my converts with them. Like I say, I'm going to ask my converts to run out a little bit, all my children who got saved since Sunday morning, to run out a little bit, run out, just run out, let me give you all my babies. I'm not going to see you again for now, just run out. Everybody who got saved, come, give me a little touch. Come on, touch me down. Come on, touch me down. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. That's that. Come on, put your hands together. Touch me down. Come on, run. Somebody, yes, come on, run. Somebody, come on, yes, all my converts, come on. Where are the rest? If you're in the back, just run. I'm waiting on you. Come on, don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed. Come on, run on down. Come on, sweetie. Sweetie in the black. Come on down. Young lady in the black and white. Touch her. Come, touch me, baby. Come, touch me. Don't sit. They're just walking, so they don't know what I'm saying. But I just want all my children to touch me. Run and touch me. Look at them. And you don't supposed to sit in the back. Don't sit in the back. Sit right there. Bring stuff and sit right up in there. All right? Make sure you sit right in there. God bless you. Love you. Amen. Love you. Keep safe. All right? Mommy, love you. Oh, Lord have mercy. All right. I didn't mean all of that, but that's okay. Somebody shout glory to God. She really want to sit right there. Sit beside the apostle. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. You can already know what she's going to become. She's going to become a first lady. Somebody pray. Oh, you are better scream up in here. I'm going to be preaching on, amen, St. Luke chapter 5. St. Luke chapter 5. You ready? St. Luke chapter 5. I'm closing out this. And it read thus. And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two ships standing by the lake, But the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draw. And Simon answered and said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and I've taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. Somebody scream and say, let it down. One more time, say, let it down. And when they had done this, they enclosed a great multitude of fish where their nets break. And they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. And they came and filled both the ships, so that they began to sing. Somebody said, I am about to sing with my miracles. Oh, nobody don't like it. Say, I'm about to sing with my miracles. When Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. And he was astonished, and all that were with him, at the draught of the fish which they had taken. And so was also James and John, the sons of Zebedee, which were partners with Simon. And Jesus said unto Simon, fear not, for henceforth thou shalt catch me. And when they had brought the ships to land, they forsook all. They forsook all and followed him. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. I want to use, I use several messages preaching for 40 other years. I use several topics for this one message. But tonight I hear it so profound and clear that I hear the Lord says your miracle is a guarantee. So my subject tonight, the miracle is a guarantee. You're not screaming, your miracle is a guarantee. Somebody not say nothing. Look, come on. I say your miracle is a guarantee. Whether spiritually, whether physically, whether mentally, emotionally, wherever you want it, wherever area you want God to do a miracle tonight, whether in your house, whether in your family, whether in your, come on somebody, your career, whether in your education, whether anywhere, I don't care what the doctor says, that thing is about to be reversed tonight. Oh, come on, nobody not shout hallelujah. I said that thing is about to be reversed tonight. I reverse the breakthrough. It's coming your way. All right, let me talk about this. Amen. That you and I understand in ministry, especially the Christians, the pastors, the leaders. Every now and then we go through a rift. We have a big success here this year, and next year for some reason, all hell breaking loose. Anybody has ever been there? That sometimes all hell breaks loose, and you can't understand what's going on because God promised you success. I come to let you know God promised you success. God promised you that you're going to have more than enough. God promised you that you're going to be the head and not the tail. God promised you're going to be the lender and not the borrower. God promised you that you're going to be successful in every area of life. But somewhere along the line, God changed your season for a reason. Oh, nobody not screaming with me. Somebody shout glory to God. I said, God change your season for a reason. And every time that God change your season for a reason, he understand exactly what you're going through. Because when God want to give you more than enough, more than you can ever imagine, he have to make you go to the bottom. He have to make you hit a place of dry season. So I want you to praise God in your dry season tonight, because your dry season is a signal for a comeback. Oh, nobody over here not screaming with me. I say your dry season is a signal for a comeback. Tell about three people, I'm going through some things, and I don't wish to talk about it. There's some things you can't talk about, you gotta shout about. Come on,
tell somebody that there's some things in your life you can't talk about it, yet you just gotta shout about it. And sometimes people see you shouting, they don't know you're shouting on brokenness, you're shouting on pain, you're shouting on, come on somebody, discouragement, you're shouting on, come on, oppression. Anybody know what I'm talking about? You're shouting and you don't have a dollar to rub together. You're shouting and your job is about to go down. You're shouting and the marriage look like it's going KY. You're shouting. Nobody don't want me to preach. So some people do not understand you're shouting. But you cannot talk about it. You can't tell everybody what you're going through. You can't tell everybody that you have a midnight disaster. Anybody has ever have a midnight disaster? All hair breaking loose. But I come to remind you that in your midnight, God have a way to break your prison cell. Your prison cell is about to be open. Oh, come on, shout. Somebody come on. I come to announce on this island is the best year of my life. And I make up my mind. I'm going to, come on, I made up my mind. Come on, everything that you and I did not have, everything you and I did not get, is because of the warfare in our mind. But I've come to put the blood on my mind so I can think straight. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm going for what was stolen. I'm going for what was taken away. Come on, somebody. I want back my stuff. Right now, I said put a now on it. Somebody move your finger and say right now, I want my mind stopped. I want a change in my life. Right now, I want God to do something. I want God to vindicate for me. I want God to fight for me. I want God to fix my children. Anybody want God to fix a child? I said, anybody want God to fix your children? Anybody want God to fix your community? Anybody want God to fix your marriage? So stop acting like you're cute and just get a little warfare in your spirit. Somebody, I want God. I want God. We can fake it all we want. We can hear it up. We can mock it up. We can lipstick up. We can eyebrow up. Come on, somebody. But when you know that you're going through hell, you just gotta put on those stuff down and tell the devil, if it's war you want, it's war you gonna get. Some can I preach like I'm losing my mind? Open up your mouth and look at the devil and say, devil, if it's war you want, it's war you gonna get. I know in whom I believe. I am persuaded that he's able. Come on, somebody, now unto him that is able. Come on, somebody, to do exceedingly and abundantly and above all that you could ever think or ask of him. Scream like you're losing your blah 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 mind. God is able. Oh, nobody over here said God is able. This year God is able more than any time else. He's able to fix it. So now watch this. When I go into the book of Luke chapter 5, I realize that these disciples, they were Jesus' disciples. But my God, they know their trade. They know how to fish. They were not learners. Come on, somebody. They were experienced fishermen. It's one thing to be a learner, but it's another thing to know what you know, what you know. And what you know seems to fail you. Anybody has ever seen anything fail you yet? And you know your stuff. You know how to pray. You know how to fast. You know how to be committed to God. You know how to dedicate your life to God. And somewhere along the line, even when you are praying, something fail you. Even when you are fasting, something fail you. But I come to declare tonight, there will be nothing failing me this year. Oh, come on, nobody over here don't lie. Nothing. this year. Come on, somebody. I am going to declare I am blessed. I got favor. I have the anointing on my life. Somebody that's screaming up in here. I preach on Sunday morning that this is a year for Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 27 for me. This is my year. Come on, they don't know the scripture. I said this is the year for Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 27 for me. The yoke already come off my neck. The burden's already lifted off my shoulder. Oh, somebody not running in here. So preach, black woman preacher. Somebody shout. Come on, somebody. I hear the Lord. Somebody said, preach it. I said, this is the year that Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 27 is going to make the enemy know that when you're anointed, nothing can stop you. If you are anointed, jump up and look at the devil and say, devil, I am more than a conqueror tonight. Come, I am a master. I am more than. I feel like preaching crazy. I am more than. My brother, I am more than. And I am going to get back my stop. Come on, say, look at the enemy. And say, give me back my stop. Come on, look at the devil and say, I want back my stuff. I want back my stuff. And I made up my mind. I'm going to get it back in the name of Jesus. So I asked the Lord last year, Lord, why is it that you allowed me to go through such a bad season? Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Anybody have ever asked the Lord that? Why you allow me? Nothing changed much about me. I love you. I worship you. I praise you. I pay my tithe. Why do you allow me to go through such a bad season? The Lord says, because you got to a place where you're depending on your resources. And you're depending upon man. And you're depending on nobody not screaming. Am I preaching crazy? You're depending on man. So you don't have to pray too hard to get it. But you know what time they're going to make a deposit. Somebody not screaming up in here. But I want you to have something mega. I want you to have something bigger. So for you to get what I have for you, I have to shift some things up. You're not screaming. You got it. Somebody come on, baby. Come on, bring me right there. Bring me right there. Bring me right there. Come on, bring me right there. I got to shift some things up. I got to close some doors. Yes, he got to close some doors. Can I get a witness on here? He got to move some people out of your way. He got to let some people leave the church so that they don't think that they are the only one that God can use to bless you. I feel like running through this roof. You got to make some so-called friends walk away from you. You got to make some people who sit on your board start acting crazy so that you can know you can build your church on that crazy one. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. I feel like I'm going to preach up in here. Say, go there, pastor. Say, go there. Because they're there talking that they are the one carrying the church. And so if they move, the church is going to go down. But I have good news for you. The church can't. Can I preach it in here? Aren't you glad that when some folks think that they are the only source, they are the only one make you look good, they are the only one make revival can come? Well, I come to let you know, I know of somebody by the name of Elijah. Elijah, after he just called on fire from heaven, somebody praise the name of the Lord. And because of one little Jezebel girl, I'm coming back to Luke chapter 5 in a minute. Can I go there? Say, go there. And he went to have him pity party on the juniper tree. And can I get a witness on him? He said, I even I only remain a prophet of the Lord. Somebody praise praise the name of the Lord. But what he did not know, that God got some hundreds prophet that never yet touched the star. I come to release something on this island, that God have some more people to take your place. Go on with your demon self. Somebody praise God. Don't let that spirit hold you in captivity. Don't let that spirit control your mind. Don't get depressed this year. Don't get oppressed this year. Shake that thing off you. Pick up back your boat and wash your net over again. Get ready for a launch. I don't know who I'm talking to, but somebody slap your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm getting ready for a relaunch. Oh, reset. I preached on last night, reset. God is getting ready for us to reset. Reset our purpose. Reset our destiny. Reset our program. Reset our ministry. Reset. And when you reset this time, make sure you do not allow people to take up your memory. Oh, somebody shout hallelujah. I feel like preaching. Somebody lift up your hands and scream like you're losing your mind. Say reset. Say relaunch. Say go back again. Oh, nobody don't want me to preach. I say reset. Relaunch. Go back again. Oh, you don't hear what I say. If you never get another word in this island, remember this crazy black woman said, reset, relaunch, and go back again. Scream up, ay-ay-ay-ay-ay. Come on, ay-ay-banda. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. Oh, scream up. Oh, scream. Oh, scream. Oh, scream. Oh, oh. Don't let your past hold you. Don't let what people say hold you. Don't let what people do to you hold you. Somebody shout glory. Get ready for a reset. Get ready for a relaunch. And get ready to go back again.
Pastor, now I understand. Amen. I'm just going to put this in there. It's not in my message. I was talking to one of my administrators from the church. Because I got a copy. I got one for MJDM, as you know. And I got one, two for the three churches that I pastor. So each administrator. So I was talking to one of the main ones. To the thick and the thin, she's with me. So you can release some information. You can't even release everything to everybody now. Because you don't know if they have the vision. You got to wait until they buy the vision. Oh, you're not screaming with me. And so I told her something. She bust out laughing, and I think you're going to laugh. I said, I'm have a sign on me. You can see it in the natural, but I want you to know it's on the spiritual. I have a sign on me. There is no room renting in my head. It's already loaded. Come on, with dreams and vision and direction. Oh, come on, you're not screaming with me. Don't let nobody rent no space in your head. There's no space for rent in my head. Oh, come on, nobody, you know what I'm saying? Tell the devil there's no space. So all your negativity, all your sin, everything you're coming with, you better take it back because there's no space in my head. Already occupied. My dreams, my vision, my goals, my future, my purpose, my life. Come on, somebody. So watch this. The disciples decided one night, we have toiled all night long, and we caught nothing.
can you imagine how ungrateful they are? One night, things not working for them, and they're ready to throw in the towel. The Bible says they turn the boat down, and they wash their nets, and get it ready to move off the shore. Not understanding that God was only giving them a shift. This is a year for a mighty shift. Oh. My vision is too big for where I am located. Oh, nobody didn't get it. I gotta go home. I'm gonna throw the mic, let the woman of God just carry on. You don't hear what I say. God shipped you for one reason. Your vision is too big for the place you occupy. Oh, Shabasa. Your life is too much of a value to who you are connected with in the house. You have people in your house talking you, calling you fool, calling you, come on somebody, ugly. You have people in your house calling you, no, you're good for nothing. God said, I'm going to shift you out of that environment. Come on, how about? You have people that disrespecting you. Come on, somebody. God said, I'm shifting you. I'm moving people from away from you that don't know your worth. Come on, I'm a diamond in the rock. Come on, I feel like preaching crazy tonight. I'm a diamond in the rock. I want everybody to know this is the year. You don't mess with this thing right here. Come on, somebody. I am going to go for broke. I'm going for what God promised me, and you won't stop me. And if you can't hang on me, buy a chair and sit down and watch me bless. Chair, so you're gonna be sitting there. You're gonna need to sit down, because when the blessing overtake me, you have a whole lot of long time to watch me bless. Because it won't be just a February blessing, it won't be just a March blessing, it won't be just an April blessing. So all those that walking around talking about nothing much gonna happen to my ministry, I got good news for them. Oh, come on, somebody. You don't see nothing yet. God is anointing my life for such a time as this. Nobody. Oh, come on. So you're just a part of the puzzle. Anybody trouble you last year, they were a part of the puzzle. Can I get a witness on here? They were a part of the puzzle, because God had to use you to push me to where I want to go. I don't mind God using you, because if you're not on my side, you're against me. If you're not with me, you're against me. And those that are not with you, sometimes God use them. Come on, to push you. Listen careful to what people said. Listen to what people said about you. Listen to what people said about your church. Can I get a witness on here? They said you're never gonna make it. Just listen to what they say, because God is gonna turn around and use them like the Egyptians to bless you before you get out of it. Oh, come on, nobody not screaming. I feel like preaching my black praise. Somebody said, preach it. Get up and shake the devil off you. No time to cry. Weeping on the last for a night. The joy of it in the morning. Say, morning is here. My breakthrough is here. My deliverance is here. My healing is here. Oh, come on, scream up in here. I'm coming back. I am coming back. I am coming back. I prophesy over this island. You're going to see change. Say change. Up in your mouth and say change. Say So immediately, bishop and pastors, the disciples, they turned the boat down because one whole night they caught nothing. So they turned the boat down and they washed the net. And can I tell you, good God Almighty, that as they turned the boat down and as they washed the net, Jesus showed up on the broken season, up on their dry season. Aren't you glad that Jesus is about to show up on your dry places? This message is not for those who are on their way. Oh, come on, somebody, to the greatest place yet. This is for this message for those who believe it is over. It's not over until God says over. This night is your night for a mighty comeback. And I come to release a comeback spirit in this island. Oh, nobody not shouting like you're crazy. I said, I come in the name of Jesus to release a mighty comeback. I bring a comeback to you and your ministry. I bring a comeback to you and your family. I bring a comeback to you and your ministry. Everything that you have lost, God is going to give you back triple. Oh, somebody shout. Say triple.
So what God does, First Lady, this is what he did. Jesus said, let me the boat. If you notice, he did not say, give me the boat. He said, let me your boat. Anything that God borrowed from you,
he's giving you back with interest. Somebody bless it, coming back with 22% interest. Somebody that's screaming with me. Oh God, I feel a shout up in here. Oh, I see some hands around there. I see some crazy worshipers up there. Oh, I see some great. Come on, there's a great expectancy in this place. I said, God is going to give you back your boat with interest. He's going to give you back your boat being anointed. That's why I started off this Sunday morning. All we need to do is first get anointed. Release people out of your spirit. Come on, nobody that I release. I give you 60 seconds to get up and touch your and go to heaven. I said, God, help me to release some people out of my spirit. Somebody hurt me. Somebody lied on me. Somebody messed with me. But I release them tonight. Oh, you know, opening up your mouth. I release those that backbite me. I release those that cost me pain. I release those that talk about me like a dog. I release those that hurt my spirit. Oh, nobody that's screaming. I said, take a minute and release them. Get them out of your spirit. Oh, Bashatayaya. Get your mother-in-law out of your spirit. Get your in-laws out of your spirit. Get them out of your spirit. They talk about you, woman of God, but get them out of your spirit. Remove to your next season. They left your church in pieces. They left your church in confusion, but release them. Oh God, I feel a preaching here. Yes, 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 yes. They left you hurt. They left you crying. They left you broken. But release them tonight. You're in a good good season. You're in a good place. The year of the anointing, the year of favor, and the year of victory. Oh, come on, you're not saying amen. Release them. Release them. Release your associate. Release your deacon. Release your clerk. Release your administrator who plot against you that you must not get nothing from the church. Release them. Release them. Release that lying culprit who plot against the ministry. Release them. I feel a release. Release them. Somebody said, drive them out of your spirit. Drive them out of your spirit. Don't take them home. Don't carry them home with you tonight. Father God, I pray for a release. Don't let me think about them. Don't let me have no heart against them. Oh, come on, I feel a preaching. Say, preach, black woman, preach. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Say, neighbor, whatever you're going through, I declare right now that you release them. Release them tonight in the name of Jesus. Don't let the month be over until you release them, because February is the month of coming back. It's a month of restoration. It's a month of fresh start. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. It's a month of fresh start. Nobody not screaming. Everybody open your mouth and say fresh. Say fresh. Say fresh start. Say fresh start. Say yes, God. I'm ready for a fresh start. Come on, anybody ready? Say fresh. Come on, come on, say fresh start. I'm gonna start by my business. I'm gonna start by my daycare. I'm gonna start by my ministry. I'm gonna start back. Come on, nobody not screaming. I'm gonna start by my corporation. I'm gonna start by my bus drive. I'm gonna talk. Oh, you're not screaming. Say fresh start. Say fresh. Say fresh. Come on, say fresh, fresh. Let everybody hear fresh start. I'm not living like this. I'm not going down like this. Somebody said fresh start. I'm not gonna go down. I'm going back. I'm going back to school. I'm gonna get my degree. I walk by my master's. I walk by my PhD. Oh, somebody scream. Say fresh start. Say fresh. Say fresh. Say fresh. Say fresh. Say fresh start. Say fresh start. Say fresh start. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Said I want fresh start. And when I go back to Jersey, this message is not only you. I've been praying since the days 1 January. I said, God, I want double for my trouble. Everybody that made me cry, I need double for crying. I need the double for that crying. Somebody, anybody that left my church, if one person left the church, I want 10 for that one. Oh, you're not screaming with me. Say, you better let me preach up in here. So the Bible says, wash the nets, turn on the boat. And Jesus said, let me the boat. He took the boat. He turned on the boat. And he taught the people. I always put this in. Have you ever been abandoned? And have you ever been rejected? Have you ever, people think that you have no more value in your life? They used to hang around you and eat lunch with you after Saturday and find a new crowd. Because they think you're broke and busted. They used to come around you because they think you have something to offer. But when they realize that you're empty, nobody wants to do anything.
they did not remember is that the boat used to be a blessing. What they did not remember is that the net used to catch. Things used to happen from the boat. Things used to happen from the net. It happened that Jesus had to come in. He came in and he stood on the boat. Taught the people on the boat. Every word that came out of his mouth, the anointing fell on the boat. Word can make a miracle happen. Life and death is in the power of your tongue. I'm going to give you some tips how you're going to be breaking out this year. I want you to put three things on your mirror. Three things. This year, everywhere you go, put three things. Put the word, put the praise, and put the dance. Put the word, put a praise, and put a dance. If you ever put a word on some dry places, it can turn around into a miracle. My God, I feel I'm preaching tonight. Put a word. How many of you are going through some real hardships in life? How many of you just going through, you're going through? You don't wish to tell nobody what you're going through, but you're going through. And you see, one of the things that we need to stop doing as preachers, stop being phony. Every one of us got a season that we go through. Come on, somebody. But every season we go through, come on, is a time for a turnaround. And I want to tell you that Jesus put the word on it. Put the word. Put the word. So when you go home tonight, put the word in your house. Just walk around and just read the Bible. Just read the Bible. Just read Psalms 91. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide. Oh, nobody not screaming. Somebody, come on, mama, I serve the Lord. He's mine. Oh, 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 somebody shout. Put a word on it. But put Deuteronomy chapter 28 on it. Come on, let the devil know you're going to be blessed going out and blessed coming in. You're going to be blessed in the city, blessed in the field. You're going to be above and not beneath. You're not screaming at me. Can I give you some scripture to put a word on it? Somebody said, I'm going to put a word on it. Put Isaiah on it. No weapon that form against me shall prosper. And every tongue that rises up against me, you shall condemn it. Oh, nobody not screaming. Put Exodus on it. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Be a Moses. Tell Moses, come on, Moses, and pull me out. Come on, somebody. Let the spirit of Moses pull you out. Come on, tell Pharaoh to let my people go. Oh, I feel a release out of your bondage. Let my people. They finished with the boat. He said, now, here's the boat. Here's the boat. But I'm going to give you instruction. This is a year of miracles with instruction. You have to hear what God is saying. We listen to too much fluff, garbage in our churches. In my church, I chose this year who I'm going to put behind the pulpit. I want people who's going to release a strong wind of anointing in my place. I want people when they come, something happen after they're gone. I want anybody to speak over my life, it must manifest quickly. I need somebody to carry a quick manifestation. Oh, you're not screaming. I know you don't like me.
Say, I need a quick manifestation of all the hell that I go through for 10 years. I need a quick manifestation. I want signs and wonders followed after. Oh, somebody, oh, come on, screamer. Anybody want something to happen? I leave a quick manifestation in this island. I said, I'm leaving a quick manifestation. Turn around and tell about 7 people. It's a quick manifestation. Come on, tell, come on. Speak it. The Lord said to speak it tonight. He gave me this word. He said, let the people open up their mouth. And man of God, when you, I don't know if you can make it tonight, but tomorrow morning by 6 o'clock, you jump up out of your bed and just walk around your church as a quick manifestation for what the enemy looking for happen. I need you to do a quick manifestation. A quick manifestation. I leave a quick manifestation. Oh, when you go back up your assignment, I give you a quick manifestation. Everything that I've been locked up, every doors that I've been closed, every lie that I've been told, I send a quick manifestation. I send the door to be open. I send an angel right now. I send an angel right now. I send an angel right now. Oh, angels of God, go do that quick. Somebody release an angel on your behalf. Somebody, come on, open your mouth and release the angel. I say, release your angel. Don't let nobody talk to you right now. Release your angel. Open up your mouth and say, I release the angels of God right now. Oh my God, I feel a miracle. I feel a miracle, man of God. Somebody scream like you're losing your mind. I send an angel. I send the angel. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. I prophesy. 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 Somebody shout up in here. Somebody praise God up in here. Come here with me. I send the angels. I send the angel before you. I send the angel. Come on, work your angel. Work your angel this year. Work your angel this year. Oh, come on. God says, I will give the angels charge over you. Oh, God, I feel. I pray for a quick manifestation. I release an angel on your behalf. Every miracle you need tonight, it shall be so. It shall be so. Woman of God, come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Every tears you shed. Every broken spirit. God is going to give you a miracle. Your body's getting energy to enjoy what's coming. You shall mount up with wings. Oh, da 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 basa. You're in a mountain of season. God says you're in a mountain of season. God said you're in a mountain of season. You shall mount up with wings. Like an eagle. Can I get somebody break out with a praise for this woman of God? Somebody open your mouth and praise God for her breaking out. Healing. Miracles. You shall be healed from the top of your head to the very sole of your feet. The blessings of the Lord make you rich. I know sorrow. Everything has been removed. Everything has been removed.
Oh God, I feel a shot. God just do a remove. He just move everything in your life. He remove. He go through your body. Remove. He go in your coma shata yamahaya. He goes on the area you live and remove. Oh come on, no strange people not gonna be living here. Oh sata the ha yamasete de lebasa. Come on, somebody raise your hand. It shall be removed. I'm just about 10 more minutes in this message. Then I'm going to bring you home. Don't leave me hanging. I feel of myself to this. Pour my strength right there. Your breakthrough has the back of India. He gave them back the boat. He gave them back the boat. You see the praise you sent up to God? He just sent it back loaded. You got it, you got it, you got it, you got it. But somebody didn't get it. Somebody didn't get it. I gotta say it again. Every praise you and I send up to God. Every worship that you and I send up to God, He has released it back down to you, and it coming down loaded. Come here, baby girl. Come here, baby girl. Come here, you. Oh, somebody, I feel a hold of my shit today. Okay, if you have never sent up a praise, send it up right now. Send it up right now. I said, send up the praise right now. Come on, come with me. Come here, baby. Come here. Come behind her. Send up the praise right now. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, whatever you need, just send up the praise right now. Praise God like you never praised Him before. We will hear about it. Eyes have not seen. Ears have not heard. Neither does it end in the heart. Don't judge the book by the cover. Something loaded coming. Put a date on it. Put a date on it. But while you're putting the date on it, put a praise on it. You shall see the miracle of God. Come on, rejoice with her. I said rejoice with her. I said rejoice with her. I feel the anointing strongly in this place, man of God. The revelation that I'm going to bring home this message with is going to blow your mind. I think I'm preaching like that, but God just showed me something. God is not going to change your address yet. All those of you that are trying to run away because of your enemy, your address will not be changed yet. Yes, 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 yes. That's a revelation from God. That's a revelation from God. I gotta say that one more time. Have you ever wondered why the embassy turned you down? Have you ever wondered why you're gonna get a visa? You will get the visa. You will experience another country. But God knows if you once leave, you won't come back. And your enemy is going to think that you're probably dead or something. So God said, what I'm going to do, I'm going to hold up every
another thing to bless you in the eyes of. Oh, come on. Somebody praise the Lord Jesus. Anybody destined to be blessed, raise your two hands and shout. I know I'm preaching long, but I've got to release it. I said you are going to be blessed.
Stay right there, don't move. Stay right there and praise God. Stay right there. I'm working on a message that I'm going to preach at SESI conference in New York. I'm working on that barrier breaker, line crosser. I'm a barrier breaker. I'm a line crosser. I'm going to break every barriers from over my life. But I'm going to break barriers in my community. Let me tell you this. The same boat that was rejected, the same net, and the same water. Nothing was changed about the boat. Am I preaching the Bible? Go back and read. Nothing was changed about the net, and nothing was changed about the water. It was just a different location. Launch out. In other words, be aggressive. Go deeper. If you prayed for one apartment house last year, pray for two this year. God is going to give you a nevertheless miracle. You don't think that is going to happen, but God says, because you trust me. Oh no, you like it. Because you trust me. Because you praise me. He said, launch out into the deep. Cyrus says, nevertheless, at thy word, at your word, God, I will let down the net again. Throw the net into the deep. What take them years to catch. They have never had a net breaking experience. 2017 is a net breaking experience. You're too nice here tonight. Whoa. I'm done. I can't go nowhere else with this. 2017 is a net breaking experience. Let me start from the spiritual down. We got to use order. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness. You see, people are seeking for money and land and houses first, but seek God first. If you ever start just be obsessed with God, obsession. Oh yeah, and that's where I'm at right now. Call me fanatic. You can stop my shout this year. Or some of you sit down there waiting for somebody to anoint you with some oil and tell your word before you jump and shout. You better start shouting right now and pull down every stronghold from over your head. I'm done. You just don't worship God. So today you should see me. You would think that I am crazy. Somebody passing would think I'm crazy, because I smell my miracle, I feel my miracle, I see my miracle, and I'm walking in my miracle. Oh, nobody not shouting. I said I feel it, I smell it. Anybody smell your miracle? Come on, somebody. Anybody sense it? I smell it. So sometimes I just thought, somebody, Bible, no music. But when you know that, you know that you won't be in church when this miracle hit you. Come on, you won't be in church when this miracle hit you. You won't have no keyboard, and you won't have no drums, and you won't have no, somebody pray. You just gotta learn how to shout without the music. And sometimes the music is off guard, they're off keys. Come on, somebody, and you can get your proper dance. Sometimes the music not playing according to what you're feeling. You just gotta leave them behind and just stop. Somebody shout glory to God. And sometimes you can't get nobody help you shout. But when you know that you know that you know that Joshua didn't have a whole bunch of people to get down the Jericho wall. Come on, somebody. It was a few people. He just started shouting, and Jericho walls coming down. I see your Jericho walls coming down flat this year. Your Jericho wall have just come down. Your Jericho wall have just come down. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Come here, right here, right here. Your Jericho walls have just come down. Your Jericho walls have just come down. I don't know what you've been going through, but God just give you a breakthrough. Somebody shout glory to God in this place. My God, I wish you could help me run this thing. Your Jericho wall just come down. Say yes up in here. 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 Hey, ba 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 ha ha. Shada da 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 da. And your Jericho walls have just come down flat. Your boat has just restored. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. God just give you a miracle. God just give you an open door. Somebody lift up your hand and give God praise. Remain standing. Remain standing. Remain standing. Something big is happening in this place. Oh yeah, da 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 da. You will never be the same again. You know why you have to release the people who hurt you? I'm giving you a clear instruction. You know the reason why you have to really release them? When you come back with your net-breaking experience, you have to beckon to them as well. Come and help us. The blessing is too much for me. That's the season I'm walking into. I need about 31 of you just walk out and said, I'm in another season. Come on, switch. Said, I'm in another season. Come on, start shouting wherever you stand up. I'm in another, come on. Oh, somebody, come on, somebody, come on, somebody, come on. I'm in another season. I'm in another season. I'm in another season. Come on, come on, come on. That's it right there. Somebody, come on. Grab your neighbor and say, come with me. I'm going in another season. Say, come with me. I'm going into another season. Somebody been stuck. Somebody been broken. Somebody been...
Come on, barren. Somebody have been barren. Somebody not barren. Grab your neighbor and say, come with me. Come with me. I'm going in another season. Come on, shout with your neighbor. Shout with your neighbor. Hey, da 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 da. That's it, that's it. The anointing. Let the anointing, let the anointing. Said in the name of Jesus, I pull you out tonight. I pull you out. I pull you out. Somebody at the back, grab your neighbor, say, I pull you out of that season. I'm going in another season. Oh, come on. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, 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 yes. Something is happening. Something. Somebody open your mouth and speak in that language. Get under the anointing. Come on, get under the anointing. Fully charge your battery. Charge up 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 your battery. I'm going in another season. I'm moving from this dry place. I'm moving from this disgusting place. I'm moving from this empty place of my life. Yes, God Almighty. So pull your neighbor, say, neighbor, I am not leaving you. I'm going in another season. I'm going in another season. It's my time to be blessed. Oh, come on. I'm going in another season. Man of God, I pull you into my season where I'm going. Somebody shout glory to God. Woman of God, I pull you into my season where I'm going. I pull you into my season where I'm going. A season of blessing. A season of woman of God, first lady. I pull you into my season where I'm going. Somebody grab your neighbor by the hand. I said, I'm not leaving you busted. I'm not leaving you broken. I'm not leaving you crying. I am pulling you in another season. Lord God, I want to finish tonight. I feel like preaching like I'm losing my mind. Somebody praise him. I'm going in a new season. Pull your neighbor, say, come. I am not leaving you. You are going to be blessed. You are going to experience a net breaking. It's 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 a net breaking season. I am not. I need about 40 of you run up here with your hand raised. Everybody run up here with your hand raised. Just start shouting. Oh, shala ba 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 ba. Oh ya ba 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 dere. Oh da 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 la masata. I feel the Joseph anointing. I feel the Joseph anointing. Can I give you a piece of roll? She brought it for me. I didn't bring it from the state. But as of tonight, wherever you go, the Joseph anointing is gonna follow you. It's gonna follow you. It's gonna follow you. It's gonna follow you. In the name of Jesus. Yes, the palace is your destiny. The place to go up. The place to go up is your destiny. You shall live and not die. You will never be ashamed. Oh, you will never be ashamed. I throw this anointing to you. Catch it and walk into your purpose as of the. Oh, that's the Joseph anointing. That's the Joseph anointing. That's the Joseph anointing. Somebody. Oh, come on. The Joseph anointing. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him. The Joseph anointing. I pray for the Joseph anointing. Lift up your hand, open your mouth, don't look around. Open your mouth. I pray for the Joseph anointing. Say yes. Say yes. Read it in the I pray for a miracle. I pray for a net breaking. I pray for a turning around. I pray for a reset. I pray for the abundance. I pray for revelation. I pray for intervention. I pray for favor. I pray for the anointing. Let the overflow. Let the oil run. Let the oil run. Let the oil run. In Jesus' name, somebody praise God. Let the oil run. 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 Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Let the oil run. Let the oil run. Let the oil run. Let the oil run. Praise him. Praise him. The woman in the black and white. Catch this. Catch this. Come on. Catch it. Don't let it drop. God said to tell you, as of tonight, you will never be in a dry place in a dry season. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Say yeah. Yeah. Ah, yada. Remember me. Remember me, Joseph. Remember me. It's gonna happen. Remember me. Don't forget me when I get back to the stage. It's gonna happen. The Lord is gonna give you people. The Lord is gonna give you open door. The Lord is gonna give you rest. The Lord is gonna give you burrows. Somebody shout glory to God. Borrow from the Egyptians. Hey, you're walking upon acres. You're walking upon new promises. You're walking up in new assignment. Oh, somebody shout glory to God. God is giving you a new assignment. Walk in it. The new assignment is here. The new assignment is here. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You are no grasshoppers. You are not grasshoppers. Go deal with the giants. Say, mama, baby. Deal with the giants. I said, deal with your giants. Deal with your giants. For years I've been acting like people better off than me. People running down big name preachers. The Lord told me, he says, listen, there's nothing bigger in no name. It's all into the anointing. Oh, you didn't get me. Woman of God, I give you this. I release this to you. It's your time. It's your season. Somebody shout glory to God. Oh! Did I say there's nothing big about name? Joseph's name would not be big if there was not a dream. I feel like preaching real crazy. I told you I was gonna preach 8 messages in one night. There was nothing big about Ruth. It was her associate. Oh gosh, there is nothing big about name. It's all about the anointing. I have one last one. Let me see the hands of every unsaved in here first. Let me see the hands of every unsaved, every backslider. Raise your hand. You're not saved. You're saved. You're saved. You don't have to worry about it. It's saved. You came last night. You're saved. We're going to let the devil stop messing with people's mind.
Once you accept the Lord Jesus Christ, God bless you. You're going to give your heart to the Lord tonight. Is there one more? Is there one more? Is there one more? Is there one more person who decide that you're going to give your heart to the Lord? I want you to catch this. I'm releasing things. Everywhere you go, there must be a breakthrough. The Lord says, stop thinking small. Stop thinking about, I don't have the money. If I have the money, I would do this. If I have the money, I would do that. Think about how God is going to use the little and nothing you have. Turn things around for you. Just like I said to the man of God, I almost want to say, remember me. To give me piece of the property. Remember me to give me a piece of the business. It's going to happen. Things about to turn around. Every tears that you shed. Every brokenness of your life. God is going to repair it. Oh, you have a seat. I hand you this crossover. I don't have another piece of cloth. But what I do have, I have go through. I didn't bring that piece of, I didn't bring those rods here. The first lady saw me giving away my handkerchief every night, and she did that. Because listen, I feel not just the Joseph anointing, I feel the Elisha and the Elijah. You throw the mantle and miracles start happening. I want you to do something. As many as you can, just hold out your hand. Put some oil and do what the Lord said. I'm going to hand over. I'm going to pick up a seed offering. I'm going to do a seed offering. Amen. I'm going to do a seed, not an offering, but a seed, a seed, a seed. And I know some of you saying, you know what? I can't give nothing. I'm not working. God says, give that. Put a seed on the job you need. Put a seed on the visa you need to come. Put a seed on the house you need to start build. Put a seed on the bills that you owe and can't pay. The light is about to cut off. Put a seed on it tonight. Somebody not screaming with me. Put a seed. Put a seed on the light. That's the anointing. That's the anointing. That's the put a seed on it. Put a seed on it. Put a seed on it. Seed on it. When you get that oil in your hand, just start do something. I need you to open up your mouth and just start anoint yourself and say, I break the empty boat and the net that is, I need a refilling in my boat. Come on, speak to your boat. Come on, start crying out. Anoint yourself, anoint your hands, anoint your ears. Your eyes will not be blind no more. Oh, come on, oh Shabbat. Those of you at the back, run up for select. Come on, stretch your hands out. Let the man of God come down to you. Under the lalabosa, to the lalabosa. Come on, anoint yourself. Speak over yourself. Speak over yourself. Encourage yourself. Encourage yourself. Encourage yourself. I speak over myself. I speak over myself. I speak over myself. I speak over myself. Somebody praise him. Speak over your life. Speak over your life. Speak over your life. Somebody come on, praise the name of Jesus in here. Oh, fill it up, Lord. Fill it up, Lord. Fill it up, Lord. Fill it up, Lord. Somebody come on, praise the name of Jesus. My de la, I need about 30 of you who will just go 29, 28, because I got two already. 29 persons who will take a seed of $100 and said, I'm putting a seed on my boat. My empty boat, my misery boat, my failure boat. Come on, nobody not talking with me. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, Hold that. Without the sound of a music. Because somebody just shifted in a minute. The hands that were anointed. Begin to anoint yourself without the sound of a music. Because you were just doing it. Anoint yourself that today your season has changed. That's it right there. Open now. Open up. Open up. Open up now. Floodgate. Floodgate. Come on, speak over yourself. 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 Start shouting. Start shouting. Come on, 1, 2, 3. Lift up your hands and shout. My God, you just break something from over your ministry and your life and your family and your own. Come on, one more time, shout! Hey, yeah, yeah, that's it. Go ahead. Don't let nobody crop. Don't let nobody paralyze you. Anoint yourself, anoint your seat. Anoint your head. If there's a pain in your body, put your hand right there. If the doctor's gonna make any diagnosis, if the doctor give you an appointment, if the doctor says something wrong with you, put your hand in your breast, put your hand in your back, put your hand on your belly, put your hand in your throat. Something is burning. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. 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 Lord have mercy. Watch the thunder. Fire. 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 Shout out fire. Shout out fire. Holy Ghost fire. Fire. Burn. Fire. Burn. Fire. Burning. Fire. Burning. Fire. Burning. Fire. Burning. Fire. Burning. Fire. Burning. Fire. 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 Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Fire. In this place, put your hand on your back, put your hand on your ears, put your hand on your mind, put your hand on your head, put your hand on your throat, put your hand on your body. Oh, dry it up, burn up it. I send the fire of Holy Ghost to burn up. I send the fire of God, I send the fire of God, I send the fire of God, I send the fire of God. I send the Holy Ghost fire. I send the fire. I send the fire. Throw some fire in your house. Throw some fire in your community. Throw some fire against your neighbors. Throw some fire. Fire. Burn up. I am a man. I am a man. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Fire, fire, I say fire, somebody say fire, Holy Ghost fire, send it in your neighborhood, send it down, send it across your neighbor, send it, send it, send it in St. Thomas, send it in Nevis, send it in, send it in St. Thomas, send it, send the fire. Send the fire in St. Martin's. Send the fire in New Jersey. Send the fire in New York. Send the fire in Chicago. Send the fire in Los Angeles. Send the fire. Holy Ghost fire. Burn up, burn up. Burn up the witches. Burn up the warlocks. Burn up the seaman. Burn him up. Oh, I send the fire in Louisiana. Control the thoughts of my son in the name of Jesus. Send the fire in the
jail house. Send the fire in the jail house. Send it in the jail house. Oh Father, send the fire, Jesus. I got to come down. Somebody pray me down. Somebody pray me down. Somebody pray me down. Send the fire in the jail house. Send the fire in the jail house. Ah, send it in the jail house. Send it in the school. Send the Holy Ghost fire. Send it on the piece of property. Send it in the piece of property. Send it to the loaner. Send it to the loaner. Oh yeah. Fire. Give me favor with the banker. Give me favor with the banker. Give me favor with the banker. Give me favor with the seller. Give me favor with the seller. Give me favor with the city. Give me favor with the government. Give me favor, Lord. Somebody say fire. Somebody say fire. Somebody say fire. Pass the fire. I send the fire of God to go before you. A fire by day. Oh, come on, somebody. A fire by night and cloud by day. Somebody shout glory to God. Oh, come on. He's a light to my feet. Come on, somebody. A light to my path and a lamp to my feet. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Come on, Joshua. Come on, Joshua. Come on, Joshua. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies, and my foe came upon me to eat up my flesh, they must stumble. They must stumble and fall. Lord Jesus, help me. Let me get out of here. Let me get out of here. You're wrong to call me. You're wrong to call me. Don't you trouble Zion. Don't you trouble Zion. Zion have a key to open sinners' heart. Don't you trouble Zion. Somebody praise your Shama. Fill with the Holy Ghost. Fill with the Holy Ghost. Fill with the Holy Ghost. Ah, yeah. Say yes. Say yes. Yeah. Say yes. 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 Yes, Lord. Send him to Jairus' house. Ah, yeah, ma. Yeah. I don't know where you live. I don't know where you live. But just take a turn around one last time. Bear with me. I know I'm late. I'm just so sorry that the Holy Ghost using me like this tonight, because somebody cannot take it. But turn around to your direction of your house, to your business, to where you want God to move. And somebody stretch out your hand and say, Jesus! 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 Hey, hey! 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 Somebody say Jesus one last time. Say Jesus! Jesus!
I under the anointing. Oh God, help me, Jesus. I am not drunk as you suppose. For it's just the third hour of the day. But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, I'm gonna pour out my spirit upon all flesh, y'all. Yeah, 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 yeah. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Oh, the young men shall see vision, and the old men shall dream. Say Jesus, say Jesus. Oh, somebody break the back of the enemy. Say Jesus. Drive out the enemy. Say Jesus. Break off the wheel of Pharaoh chariots. Break off the wheel. Take off the wheel. Take off the wheel of Pharaoh chariots. Oh, going by my Monday. Take off the wheel of Pharaoh chariots. Let me see 28, who's going to sow the seed. Just say, I'm going to sow the seed. I am putting a seed on this thing tonight. I already break forth and I'm putting a seed on it. Come on. One seed. You put your words in your hand. One seed. A seed of $100. One seed. One seed. One, two, three, four, five, six. Come on. You should be running. This is a one-time seed here tonight. Somebody not screaming with me. Oh God, I feel about shake it over, sir. The man of God gave his already. Oh, mama, sir. Come on, bring that seed. Don't even wait. Say Jesus. Come on, don't move. Come on, lay down on your seed. Just lay down on your seed. Stay right there and talk to your seed. Don't move. Anybody else bringing the seed? Come on, sit right there. Talk to your seed. Sit down. Sit down and talk. If you're gonna bring it, sit down and talk about. Sit down and talk to it. Talk to your seed. Come on. If you're bringing that seed, come on. Sit down. Sit down at the altar and talk to your seed. Break the powers of wickedness. Break the back of poverty. Oh man, master. Man of God, you give your seed already. Just sit down and talk to your seed. You and your wife, just take a seed. Take a sit. Come on, somebody. Go get your seed and come. Go get your seed and come. If you don't have $100. Seed, get a $50 seed right now. Come on, get a $50 seed and come talk to your seed. Come quickly. No, come on. If you don't have a $50, get your $20 seed. Come on, get your $30 seed, your $25 seed. Come on, in the name of Jesus, sit down and talk to your seed. Sit down and talk to your seed. Oh, come on, bring it. $5 seed, sit down all over the place. Kneel down on the chair, kneel down on the ground, sit down on the pulpit, sit down, sir. The devil must know your mean business. Tell the devil, get off my seed. Come on, declare, I'm gonna pay my bills. I'm gonna pay my bills. I'm gonna pay my light bill. Oh, come on, shout. Shout, talk to everybody. Come on, find a seed and bring it up. Bring $1, bring $2, bring $3. Stand up all over the altar. Talk to your seed tonight.
Oh, talk to your seed. I said, talk to your seed. Tell the Lord you need a breakthrough this year. It's the first month of the year. Oh, first fruit is the first month of the year. Come on, pray, pray, pray. Come on. Any way you want to turn, you just turn and pray. Oh, come on. Joy of ascending. Come on, somebody need to come up. Come with your $5. Come with your 20 cents, a quarter. Come talk to the Lord. Come with your $2 seed. Oh, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, come, 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 come. Don't let that poverty spirit keep you in bondage. Kneel down and talk to your seed. Stoop down and talk to your seed. Talk to your seed. Tell the Lord God, give me a breakthrough. Somebody come on, shout. Come on, some of you need to come from home. Come, come, come. Bring a little seed. Bring a little seed. Whatever you have is a faith walk. It's a faith walk. And if God knows you don't have anything, come. If God knows you don't have a dollar to your name, come. Come. He knows. He knows. He knows. He knows. He knows. He knows by faith. By faith. Oh, Jesus. Speak over your seed. Speak over your seed. Speak over your seed. That's right, that's right. That's right, my son and my daughter. That's right, my children. Ah, yeah, 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 no Shabbat. Break the back. Break the back of poverty. 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 Break the back of poverty in here tonight. Break the back of poverty. Break the back of poverty over your life. It's a generational thing. It's a generational thing. It's a generational thing. It's a your mama don't have it. Your daddy don't have it. Your sibling don't have it. Break the back. Break the generational thing. Break it. Break it. To the bishop, put your seed down and say, I see you in the harvest. Come on, said, I see you in the harvest. Put it down and said, I see you in the harvest. I'm coming to reap you in the harvest. I'm coming to reap you. Put it down, put it down, put it down on the ground. Yeah, God. Yeah, God. Yeah, God. Yeah, God. Yes, Lord, we put your seed in. Jesus, I see you in the harvest. I see you in the harvest. I pray for every unsaved in this crowd. Every backslider tonight, I pray, I send the blood to pluck them out of the hand of the enemy. I set the fire of the Holy Ghost on their lives right now that they will never be the same again. I now declare and decree that every unsaved, every backslider coming home to know Jesus Christ. Thank you for a mighty revival upon this land. Amen. Every denomination,
will be experiencing a revival in every corner of Virgin God. They will not have enough nets, and they will experience a net breaking for the harvest that is coming. Like you said, God, to the disciples, you said to them, from henceforth, you will not catch fish, but you will go for me. I pray that, God, as I'm leaving this island tomorrow morning, you said if I go to a place and they don't receive me, that I should dust the very dust off my feet. But God, if I go, leave the blessing upon the island. And so the people have received me with an open arms. I pronounce an overflow blessing upon this island. Ayabasa. Hidideisa. I pronounce the blessing that make them the head and not the tail. I pronounce the blessing that they shall be blessed going out and blessed coming in. They will be the lender, not the borrower. No cancer will enter through their body. Every cancer cell is now shut up with the blood of Jesus. No more blood pressure, no more sugar diabetes. No more diseases in the body. There shall be an overflow, God, in this territory. I leave Sanctuary of Hope, baptizing people every week. And if it's not every week, every month. But there must be a continuous overflow. They must have jobs open up. Many could not move tonight because they don't have a seed. I now declare seed must come to them before the harvest. I pray now, God, that you will give seed to the sower. Seed. Come on, stretch your hands and say, I have received seed. And I'm going to sow back. Come on, say that. I received the seed. And I'm going to sow it back. Remember, you make a declaration before God. When he bless you, remember to sow the seed. God bless you. Thank you, Bishop, for having me. I love you. You're my brother for real. Thank you, my sister. You're my sister for real. Amen. And I don't beg preaching. I don't even give out cards to them. I don't beg preaching. I don't do that. That's not God. He says your anointing make room for you. But I'm telling you, I'm coming back to make it 20 years. So whether he wanted or not, I'll be here and then I can close it out. 20 years and I'm coming back. And I purpose I'm going to bring some people from my church in which I pastor. Amen. I'm coming right back here next year. And then it's going to be 20 years and we're going to have a party. Somebody shout glory. Come on, y'all. I know you all love me and I'm coming back. Next year will make 20 years since I'm coming to this island. And I feel like having a Holy Ghost party. And I want to see my brother and friend, amen, next year again. You don't understand. I love you and your church family. I don't know why you don't want me at your church, because you say I'm crazy. But that's all right. You think I'm crazy, but I love you. You always come. I can't be that crazy for you and your people come listening to me. But I love you, sir, and God bless you. And keep the faith. God bless you, man of God. Thank you for having me. Amen.
Come on, can you put your hands together? Let the evangelist know. We really appreciate her. Come on, somebody. Celebrate the gift and the anointing of God upon a woman's life. Thank you. Thank you. I am so glad that I love to hold people based on their words. If you make a promise, understand? I have some people, they are like elephants. They don't forget a thing. So we look forward. Some folks from our church have already sent on an axe to come for next year. So we are looking forward to have an invasion from New Jersey. I am looking forward to that, to see some of the miracles that the Lord has done. I really want to express a deep sense of gratitude. Words are truly insufficient to say thank you. We can plan all we want. We can pray. And I really want to say again to Emmanuel Baptist Church especially, I really want to thank them for partnering with us and for continuing to get the word out. I want to thank I've always said this, and it's the truth, that Pastor Gregory celebrate my victories as if they're his. Sometimes, every now and then something happened to me and I have to remind him that it's my victory, is not his. And I hope but you know, I really appreciate a good friend. And they say good friend better than pocket money. And it is true. I pray that God will truly allow his grace to shine upon Emmanuel. And as we say that, this Saturday is the last Saturday. And so we are actually going to team up together for the first time. This Saturday they're not going to meet at the college, but we're going to meet here. We're going to be here from 5 o'clock, but we're not going to leave until, is it 6, Pastor? All right, we're going to leave at 6 and march around the island as we normally do. But along with the Emmanuel Baptist Church and the prayer team from here and others, we're going to meet right here and pray for a little while, and then we're going to march around the island and celebrate what the Lord is doing. Amen. We want to thank the Lord that we are able to partner together and do this for God's glory. I want to thank those who have been praying. I know it's long, we're tired, but tomorrow is Wednesday. We normally have our midday prayer, right? And talking to the people that will pray. They say, even if it's just to come and pray. So we're going to be here from 12 o'clock until about 1:10 tomorrow. We invite you to come and just right underneath this tent, we're going to continue to saturate with the power of Almighty God, because we believe that God is not finished with us yet. Amen? So all of you normally come to the midday, and others, we invite you to come and let's share together and continue to celebrate the Lord. Pastor Gregory promised to come back Thursday night. Is it this week Thursday night? Right. I mean, so you love Maxine, but you can't leave me high and dry, no? Yes. One time I saw him walk and I thought he was gone. I said, man, gone. My God, let me. I love him. Yes. You keep, the one thing you know, as long as I have Sister Sandra here, you have to come back. She can't galang if you are galang, because you have to come back. But I know those people from Tortola. Thank you, Evangelist Teresa. Thank you. Come on, can we put hands together for her? Thank you. Thank you so much, Janine, the woman of God. Just got back from South Africa. Lord have mercy. Can the rest of us in any agona man and us go so? Alright? God bless you. But we want to say thank you again. And as we go, because I might not get to, I might overlook it. But I am so proud of the men and the women in this church. All those who work extremely hard to let the thing sound as good and look at good. Flowers garnering and all sort of things. Can you put your hands together and celebrate yourself? I am so proud of all the hard work. And I'm not going to call no name, because me know some me going to miss somebody. But Joyce, can you come? I really want to thank God. It's not everybody you can live with and go on crazy. Mad people need sane people next to them. And I am extremely glad that this woman is in my life. She would not even begin to know. Lord have mercy. Lord. And every now and then, because I have these crazy things in my head swirling around, long before I introduce them to the board, I would normally talk to Joyce. And every now and then she look at me with the eyes, and you can tell she want to say it. Rev, that don't make no sense, you know. But she's always such a darling, always willing to say, if the Lord tell you to do it, let's go do it. And I'm really happy for you. I want you to know that you are such a blessing. Thank you so much, honey. Thank you so much. Could you stand to your feet at this time? Could you stand to your feet at this time? Hurry up and we could go home. Your wish. Lord have mercy. Help me, Jesus. And now may the grace of the Lord shine upon you. May God favor you. May doors be open for you. May you walk in this new season. May victory, favor, and anointing and the miraculous truly follow you. Go with God. Love somebody as you go. Remember, the woman of God is leaving tomorrow morning early. So if you're going to hug her now. All right? God bless you. Have a great night. Thank you. Look forward to seeing many of you and others. Tell somebody about the thing, man. It'll get nicer and nicer. And see you tomorrow night.